Hey guys, it's Matthias, and I just want to make a quick upload here where I fail-spawned a loadout. I guess it's the loadout of ultimate lameness. I have the light PPA and lock-ons, the Tomcat lock-on missiles. And believe it or not, it actually came rather handy because I was attacked by quite a number of mosses here. Now, I'm not the biggest fan of this loadout, and I mean, it's a matter of opinions. Don't take it too seriously what I'm saying here, but I'm just sharing my opinion about it. I think the lock-ons, the biggest problem with them is that they lock on a little bit too fast, and they are also far too reliable. Now, there's been a lot of balanced discussions about these Tomcat lock-ons, which is what they're called, and the arguments normally sound something like this. The more experienced pilots hate them because they are low-skilled, and they kind of ruin the fun of the air game, which is, well, the fun of the air game for most pilots, that is when you're actually overcoming the challenges of using one of the nose guns and normally the external afterburners. And the reason why pilots, such as myself, for example, prefer that kind of loadouts is because that forces you to aim good, to lead good, and to maneuver good. And however well you do any of these things will affect how well you perform in an air-to-air combat situation. Now, the moment the lock-ons are put into the equation, or even the Coyotes, you just don't have enough maneuverability to counter them, even with the external afterburners, actually. And the same goes for the Coyotes. Now, this is seemingly a never-ending debate, and I have made my point clear where I stand. And the argument for these type of weapons is, of course, to help lesser-skilled and newer pilots. And, yeah, that's a valid argument. The problem with them being meant for newer pilots, however, is that they actually cost you so much that any new pilot probably can't afford them anyway. And the people that are using them are actually mostly, at least that's my experience, mostly the players that have been flying basically as much as I have or for as long as I have. And rather than improving, this is the kind of easy way out. Now, for a pilot such as myself, it's really hard to make my points and to argue my opinions without sounding condescending. And I guess this video might come across that way, even though that's not my intention. Now, a lot of people have the opinion that if you just lower the damage for each rocket, then you balance it that way. And of course, that's probably the easiest way to do it, I guess. I think that it's more about how reliable they are and how quickly they lock on. These are probably what I think is the biggest problem. I'm not really sure. And I think there's a lot of people that experience this very differently, because certain pilots will, of course, be targeted with the lock-ons more than others. And it also seems like with certain weapons, regardless of how good or bad they are, they have a tendency to follow certain trends. Like, for example, you saw the massive amount of Banshee usage just before they were nerfed, like the last couple of months before they were nerfed. And the thing is that the Banshee has always been just that powerful. As far as I know, the Banshee has always been great, but people just didn't use it because, I mean, people just didn't care. And I think this might actually affect what people think about lock-ons as well. Like, if not that many people use it, then people might think that, yeah, but they're not all that great, even though they are pretty damn good. Except for in close-range engagements like this. I actually switched them out there for the light PPA, and eventually I was able to get further away to reliably finish this mozzie off with a last Tomcat lock-on. Anyway, I just wanted to share some of my opinions, and yeah, I hope this doesn't turn into too much of a flame war. Either way, I would say thank you all for watching, and bye for now.
God, I need to open the stream.
We should have gotten the Echo account instead.
Yep, that would have been much easier.
Yeah. I mean, I still don't even have BTS downloaded.
You ready, Joel? You ready?
I'm coming, wait.